Hi! This beauty is the most expensive lamp I have ever bought. It is a 135 watts low pressure sodium vapor light bulb. There's only one problem. I haven't had the right gear to power it up. Until now. In this video, I will assemble and test three different power supplies for it, giving us a rather unique look into how well the three options perform on the same lamp. For each power supply, I'll measure lamp brightness, power consumption, power factor, and lamp temperature. Which one works the best? One of the options isn't really meant for the 135 watts lamp. Online, there are some contradicting claims as to whether it will work well or not. Let's find out. Do not experiment with high voltage gear unless you know how to survive it. I did not plan to have three different options to power up my single 135 watt sodium lamp. I have told the story behind it on Patreon, but in short, I ordered the perfectly matching gear tray from an online marketplace, but received a different one for the closely related but tweaked SOX-E 91 watts lamp. Instead of furiously returning it, I got curious after contacting the seller. He told me this BSX 91 gear was taken out of a decommissioned streetlight running a 135 watts lamp like mine. Interesting. I would like to test if that combo is not as bad as it sounds. So I ended up ordering a second option to compare with from the same seller. A dual purpose leak transformer that will also power a 180 watt sodium lamp if I ever come across one. The seller also sent for free the bits needed to upgrade the 91 watt gear tray to a proper 135 watts version, giving us the three options to try out. Can you guess how differently these three power supplies will power up the same lamp, if at all? I will start with the beefy 180 watts monster. It had a rough ride with the postal service. I'm worried if this battered up ballast even works anymore. Let me quickly check the resistance of the primary coil, which can be set for either 220 or 240 volts mains. Measuring the DC resistance of an AC transformer coil is not very telling unless you know what it should be for that particular coil. I just want to see if this bruised ballast is shorted or open before hooking it up. The offset is 0.1 ohms, which I will have to subtract since this multimeter does not have a relative function. 4.1 ohms after offset for the 220 volts tap and around 4.5 ohms for the 240 volts. Seems okay to me. To get the same wattage at 220 and 240 volts, you would need to have lower current at 240 volts. And the higher resistance we see on the 240 volts tap does exactly that, lower the current. Older versions of this ballast had a 200 volts option too, but in this newer one, it isn't connected at all. At my house, the mains voltage is rarely much above 225 volts, never 240 volts, so I will use the tap for 220 volts. After making sure the scary big capacitor is fully discharged, it is time to build the power supply. Alright, time for first light from this lamp. Hopefully. I am feeling a little nervous about this. I paid around $300 in total for the components and neither the ballast, the lamp, nor the capacitor are in mint condition. Will it all work? What a relief and a beautiful sight. If you want to know more about how these low pressure sodium lamps work, I go into details in an earlier video. Time for monitor test in a darkened room. Just making sure the capacitor will not electrocute me. It is discharge, but don't take it for granted. I'll show why later. If my memory serves me right, this will be the most comprehensive test I have ever performed. Every 30 seconds for the first 15 minutes after power-up, I will measure lamp brightness in lux, temperature on top of the glass, mains voltage, electric power in watts, and power factor. At the end of the test, I will even measure the voltage sent into the lamp itself. Here we go. This was quite intense. Had to wear sunglasses after just 5 minutes. The final reading is the lamp voltage. Scary task. This thing will power through a short circuit, so it doesn't care if it lights up the lamp or me. 161 volts. Pretty good. The nominal voltage for the 135 watts SOX is 164 volts. 161 is close enough. Let's take a look at the results from using this behemoth of a ballast. The lamp's brightness is low until it gets warm enough to evaporate the sodium. Then the light output quickly rises and, to my surprise, peaks before stabilizing at a lower output. Seems a little frisky. Maybe because it can run a 180 watts lamp too. It is definitely using a lot of power. Up to 225 watts at the peak. The power factor is, well, unacceptable by today's standard. The outer glass temperature is nicely low, but of course kept down by the relatively short runtime and not being in a closed light fixture. Now, how will the same lamp perform when powered by the 91 watts ballast? Sounds like a bad idea, but the 91 watts lamp is actually a re-rated, energy-saving version of the 135 watts. Maybe it will work fine and save me some electricity. Nice, it does light the lamp. All seemed fine, until trouble kicked in. Look away if you are sensitive to strobing light. A beep will sound when you can watch again. After a trouble-free 8 minutes and 51 seconds, the lamp suddenly started blinking. While being busy recording the readings, I had to decide whether to stop and spare the lamp or plow on for 6 more minutes. Luckily, after 38 long seconds, the power supply stabilized again and didn't blink once for the remaining 5.5 minutes of the test. I'm not happy about this incident though. The lamp voltage was also shocking. ...288 volts. Yikes! That's high after warming up for over 15 minutes. Remember, the nominal voltage for this lamp is 164 volts. For the re-rated 91 watts version, it is slightly higher, 173 volts, but not 288 volts. I guess this power supply simply cannot heat up this lamp enough, especially without a closed fixture. The 91 watts version has an improved infrared reflecting coating, keeping the inner lamp tube warm enough at the lower power. The 135 watts version is designed for 135 watts of electrical power to heat it up to optimal temperature. Its brightness is therefore disappointing on the BSX91 power supply. It warms up much slower and never reaches full potential. I measure around 28% less light than with the first power supply. Even less than expected from a 91 watts version of the lamp. Likely due to running too cold. But it does use way less power now. and the power factor is better too. Almost as specified. A little on the low side when warmed up. I think the capacitor is struggling with the lukewarm 135 watts lamp. The flickering happened at the time where there was a rise in power draw. I guess the lamp was trying to draw more power than the capacitor was capable of handling, limiting the peak power. Let me upgrade the 91 watts gear tray to a proper 135 watts version. Just checking if the capacitor is discharged. Nope. A little juice remaining, which I will drain before moving on. There we have it. After a short message, I will test it. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. Thank you so much for helping out. It's really appreciated and important for a niche channel with monthly quality uploads like mine. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link to my Patreon page in the description. Thank you. Final test. Did the upgrade make a difference? Great. No flickering this time. Is the lamp voltage closer to 164 volts this time? 166. Closest yet. We are also back at full brightness. Overall, a nicely controlled progress, ending at the same brightness as with the 108 watts brick of a ballast. Better yet, the power consumption for that same light output is lower. Oddly enough, with the peak in watts before the peak in brightness. Guess it is better balance for this lamp during warm-up than the compromising dual-purpose power supply. Power factor is close to specs and the best when warmed up. So, despite the many factors to consider, I believe the conclusion is shiningly clear. For a 135 watts lamp, I cannot recommend the BSX91. The short flickering incident alone is a big no-no for me. Could perhaps be fixed with a fresh 30 years newer capacitor, but even then, it would never light up the 135 watts lamp to full brightness. And it will likely sputter the electrodes faster, with its higher lamp voltage over a prolonged time. The dedicated BSX135 is, not that surprisingly, the balanced, sensible choice. It scores well on all parameters, highly recommended. However, for my use case, where I only will turn on the lamp once in a while for relatively short runs, the mighty L4135 is a great alternative. It quickly and effortlessly lights up the lamp, even to highest peak brightness, with less components that can fail. The power consumption and power factors suck, but it's tolerable for a few hours here and there. And as a bonus, it is the only one that can be used with the SOX 180 watts lamp too, if I ever get one. Fingers crossed. As far as I can tell, you will not find a ballast comparison like this anywhere else. If you want to study the results in more detail, I have attached spreadsheets with the data and graphs in a public post on my Patreon page. Link in the description below the video. While you wait for my next video, I recommend my video about the low pressure sodium vapor technology using an 18 watt mini SOX. Hope you liked this video enough to click like and perhaps subscribe for more. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.